Hey guys, welcome to the Sydney portion of the Eras Tour vlog. Because of how long the Melbourne one was, I decided to split it into two, a Melbourne and a Sydney one. So pretty much, I leave for Sydney tomorrow morning at I have to leave the house at 6 a.m. It is currently 10:30 at night and I haven't really packed. Or I've put stuff in my luggage, but I don't actually know what I need. So I will show you this packing and everything, and I don't even have everything charged properly. So we're gonna do all this and then I will show you what I am dealing with right now at 10:30 at night when I have to leave the house, not even wake up, leave the house at 6 a.m. tomorrow morning. Just so we're clear on a timeline, I arrive in Sydney tomorrow morning at about 10 a.m. and the Eras Tour concert is Sunday. I was supposed to go Friday and Sunday night, but I traded my Friday night ticket so my friend could go on Sunday night in Sydney with me. So, here's what I'm dealing with. I have my Melbourne portion of the vlog, which is currently being exported. It's quite a raw vlog, so are all my vlogs. That's just the style I like because I just don't have a lot of time to edit my videos. And with the Taylor content, I was like, there's nothing to edit. I'm not going to, you know, write the names of every single song down, or I'm not going to cut out clips of it because this is like me reliving my memories as well, and I wanted to keep it all so I don't have like thousands and thousands of videos on my phone about it, or hundreds, you know. Anyway, so this is exporting. It is 22% of the way. I was actually out and I was hoping it'd be all exported when I went out, but my battery died on my computer, so that's that. My goal is to pack by 12 a.m. and hopefully maybe get some rest overnight. And yeah, we'll see what happens. If not, then I'm just gonna sleep on the plane because it's like a 1 hour flight. I have officially landed in Sydney and it is so hot. I am literally boiling. It's been a crazy morning, which is why I didn't vlog any of my trip, because like I literally got to the airport like 7 a.m. I had to wake up and get out of the house at 6, and it was just too busy. There was too many things going on. Anyway, I have officially landed and I am in Sydney, so I am going to take these next few days to kind of just explore and everything. I am going to change out of this as comfy as this is. I'm just too hot because I'm wearing leggings with it. So I'm going to completely change, and just black on a hot day just is not it. It's supposed to be 31 degrees, but it's already like boiling. Anyway, I am going to explore around Sydney as if I've never been here before. I always come to Sydney. I'm going to walk around the town and just chill out for the next couple of days. So yeah. It is still Thursday. I know I said I wasn't really gonna vlog and just spend time in Sydney, but I forgot I was gonna do something Taylor related today, kind of in a sense. I was able to get some sleep. I took like a 20-minute nap and then just watched the movie, and I've been trying to upload my vlog all day and it's literally only at 20%, probably because it's 2.5 hours long. But that's okay. I am gonna go out to dinner with my dad, and that is what we're gonna do. But where he works, or just outside where he works, is where the Crown like countdown for Taylor Swift Eras Tour is. So I really wanna go take a photo there. So we're gonna go over there, or I'm gonna head over there and meet him after work to go take some photos of that. Which will be so cool because I seen it all over my TikTok and I really, really wanted to go to do that. And now I have a lot of merch to get tomorrow because a couple of my friends have just put in requests, which like I was like okay, but I'm not doing any more after that because there's just a lot of merch. So this is my makeup. I'm just doing it really light because I can't bother getting ready really, so I just put in some eyeliner and a little bit of eyeshadow, and I just did my lashes. I don't have any falsies on those, so that's pretty much what I'm doing in terms of my makeup, just because I want to like look kind of nice for the photos. Anyway, I'm gonna try and get this vlog uploaded, and I have to leave in about 20 minutes, so we'll see what we can get done. If not, then it's okay, and it's just needs to be done by Saturday. So yeah, I'll show you me at that Taylor Swift countdown clock thing. Okay, so I made it to Barangaroo. That's like the water or the ocean behind me, and this is like Crown or part of it. The Taylor Swift thing is supposed to be here, except I don't know where exactly. So I'm just gonna walk around and see if I can find it. Okay, so I'm currently at Central. It is Saturday night, and look at what's behind me. There's a Taylor Swift, like, the Eras poster. Oh my gosh, there it is! I'll show you another video of it. There it is!
pretty that is.
All right, hey guys, it is Sunday. It is Taylor Swift Day. I am just about to go to the station to meet my friend so we can have lunch before we come back to go and get ready. And I can't wait to see her. It's been like a month since I've last seen her, so yeah.
So I was there. Say hi, and we got some snacks because we're not too hungry. We got like dim sum stuff. Anyway, these are so good. So we're gonna walk back home and we're gonna start getting ready for Taylor. And yeah, I am so excited. Also, the amount of people wearing Taylor merch is like on the streets. But yeah, yay, we're gonna go get ready for Taylor and then do some TikToks and stuff like that.
Okay, so it is about 1 o'clock and Samia and I are gonna start getting freaky for Taylor. I'm so excited, but yeah, I'm going with a Speak Now look and you're doing folklore.
Yes.
So that's what we're gonna go with, and then I will show you guys maybe as we're doing it, maybe along the way, I don't know. But I'm gonna film some TikToks while doing it as well. Okay, so Samia and I are all ready. She is folklore. And I am Speak Now, and she did my butterflies. These were a pain to put on.
So
annoying. Anyway, I've got my bracelets all over my wrist. She does too. And yeah, we're just gonna head there. It's gonna take us an hour to get there.
And my strap broke.
Oh no. And we're going to preserve as much of my phone battery as possible because I think I'm gonna film a lot of things. But I am so excited. Are you?
Yes.
So excited with Taylor. Anyway, so that is my entire look. I'll show you a full. I will try to remember to do a full look later.
Okay, so we are walking. We've made it out of the train station. That was actually a really quick train ride because it only takes like an hour, but we're here. The time's about like 4:40 and we were taking photos and stuff on the train. Anyway, we're walking to the venue right now. I'm so excited. There's so many people. We've almost made it to a call. We have ice creams because of how hot it is, but a call is right 27. In front of us. Yeah, it's like 27 degrees. Yeah, it's a lot hotter than my Melbourne show, but this has been the best weather for any of the Sydney shows this weekend, so I think we got the best day. I think I picked right.
So there's a sign that says a call, and then in front of me, I don't know if you can see, there's like some merch tent, so we might see what the line is with that. We might go to those.
Thank you. said I wanted thin mints, and you said you knew a guy. You showed up with a boombox, stars in your eyes. Well, who could cuddle in on trampolines? Could be so friendless. We bonded over black eyed peas and complicated. Fell so deeply into it. It was all so innocent. All because I'm a hot topic on your phone. I'm a rebel and I'm stealing from the young. Tell me who I am, cause I don't have a choice. All because I'm a boy. I'm not catastrophizing everything.
Ah! making me feel a little too excellent right now. Look at this. I just wanna see what would happen if I were to try something real quick. Okay, now that went straight to my head. You got me feeling really, really powerful. What an absolute delight it is to say these words to you tonight. Sydney, welcome to the Eras Tour. us feel so at home, so welcome, so celebrated, so understood. And you know what? It's gotten crazier every night. Every night that we've played here. I'm looking out at a crowd that is already at a level after just a few songs that some crowds never reach in terms of partying. You're off the charts immediately from the jump. There are over 83,000 of you here tonight, and you could have done anything else with your evening, but you decided to hang out with us. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts here at the Eras Tour. You're making me feel very, very, very lucky tonight. Another thing that makes me feel incredibly lucky is I get to have the coolest opening act out there on the Eras Tour. And I would like for you to make noise once again for the brilliant and beautiful Sabrina Carpenter. So you and I, we're about to go on a little adventure together. That adventure is going to span 18 years of music, and we're going to be doing this one era at a time. How does that sound to you, Sydney? So let me tell you my little goal for the evening. These are songs that I've written about my feelings or things that have happened in my life or stories I created in my imagination, and maybe that's what you think about when you hear these songs out in the world. But I want all that to change after tonight. After tonight, I want you to be thinking about us and the memories that we made here in this beautiful sold-out stadium every time you hear these songs. I'll be your host this evening. My name is Taylor. We can be the...
Oh, Bye. I mean it. Like,
I have been absolutely like, I've just been feeling it all night. Like, and this is just the beginning of the show. I mean, this is a long show. I don't know if you've heard that. We basically play for like 17 days straight. We're just at the beginning of the show, and I am so delighted and honored to get to play for and with you, because I feel like this is a very collaborative thing that's happening. You guys are singing as loudly as I am. I have a mic. So thank you. Because honestly, like, it's just crazy to me. I haven't seen you in so long. The last time I was here on tour was in 2018. It was the Reputation tour. Since I've gotten to come see you, we had a pandemic, nobody could play shows for a long time, and I really, you know, I remember feeling like, what do I do about the fact that that connection I have with you guys, where I, like, I live my life, I experience things, I have thoughts, I want to tell stories, and I want to show them to you, and I want to connect in that way. What do I do about that? If we can't play shows and I can't dance with you and, you know, have these inside jokes with you that we develop on a tour. And so I just decided that I was going to make and release as many albums as humanly possible. So we have some major musical catching up to do. We have a bunch of albums that I've put out and to review. They're called Lover, Folklore, The Era We Are Currently In, Evermore, last but certainly not least, Midnight. And then I was very, very excited to get to tell you something a couple weeks ago, which is that it's so crazy to actually get to tell you that and to actually say that, because when you're keeping secrets for years, like, when you actually get to say the words, when you actually get to say the title, when you've been using like secret code names, and it's really fun. I'm very excited for April 19th, and we are currently in the Evermore era, and all I want to do is hear how loudly you guys can sing Champagne Problem. Thing that just happened. like a hallucination I'm having. This is, honestly, you guys are, I don't know if I've known this level that you're on. That was so loud and so nice of you to do for us. Thank you, Sydney. I would like to introduce you to someone who I'm so lucky that I get to play with every night of this tour. She is my keys player. She's phenomenal. Sydney, will you please make welcome to the stage by screaming very loudly, Karina Di Piana.
Table.
Is it true that you're in my head? Cause I know that it's delicate. Is it cool that it's getting older? Is it too soon to do this yet? Cause I know that it's delicate. Isn't it? Thank you.
gravity, shifting eyes and frequency, vanished when I saw it, starts to make its way to me. A playful conversation starts, counter all your quick remarks, like passing notes in secrecy. And it was enchanting to me.
Shut up! staring at the sunset. Or you could begin at the beginning. And in that case, please picture me in the trees. I hit my peak at 7. Feet in the swing over the creek. I was too scared to jump in, but I was high in the sky with Pennsylvania under me. Are there still beautiful things? Sweet tea in the summer. Cross your heart and tell no other. And though I can't recall your face, I still got love for you. Your braids make a pattern. Love you to the moon and to Saturn. Passed down like folk songs. Love lasts.
So I created an entire aesthetic landscape around folklore. And in my mind, folklore was like in the middle of the woods, in this cabin, and like lots of like dresses like this. And it was all very kind of bespoke. And in a time where we weren't dealing with the global pandemic and trying to figure that out and manage our emotions. So I could just kind of create stories, and it was really, really exciting as a songwriter to create characters, and those characters could fall in love and like get their hearts broken and betray each other, and obviously, you know, as I always do, I infuse my own feelings into them. But it was really fun to create, you know, there's this this character arc called the Teenage Love Triangle. Do you know about this? Up with the love of his life, and he has to try to win her back. And her name is Betty.
To the center of the name, money, and the town said, how did I make?
able to do different things every night and sort of dedicate special individual moments to each city that we were in, each show that we played, have it be different than any other show that we play. And also, like, you know, I try to like match what you're giving to us, right? And you guys have given us the absolute maximum. And just kind of like Australia in general, the Aussie fans, there's a song that you recently made number one, and it's for like a long time, so I thought I'd just do that.
No idea.
It's a fly.
Thank you.
hoping you'd be there. It's be the one thing I've been wanting. I wish you would.
I don't even know.
Good day. absolutely unforgettable for us. Sydney, thank you. We love you forever. Do you have time for one more song?
Doing things around the city.
Hey guys, so it is the day after the concert. It is currently 11:30 and I'm going to go meet my friend. I woke up at 9 and I just got ready and I did some typed up my lecture notes and stuff. Anyway, I have little to no makeup on because my face needs a break from it. But yeah, I'm gonna go walk out and go to the city and meet her.
So I'm back with Samia and we are gonna try some candy that we got. We got some Japanese candy. This is the one that I got. I just gotta figure out how to open it first. So I'm gonna open this clearly card just one-handed and then we'll come back and do a little taste test. Okay, so here it is. We're gonna try it and I'm just gonna... It's not bad. What do you think?
It's all right.
But why are you biting it? It's obviously one that you pull off.
I have one hand, I'm trying to film. Normally I would peel it.
Give it a 4 out of 10.
These are...
I don't like the flavor.
They're okay, they're not bad.
Also, they're really soft.
Yeah.
And sticky.
This is not what I thought it was. I thought it was a different kind of apple, but I still like it. It's pretty good. Okay, so we got bubble tea now. She got a lemonade and I got a strawberry one.
Yeah, wait. I just...
It's okay. Do you want to try some?
That one's good.
I'm going to try some of hers. Okay, they're both okay. I like the ice cream from this place, but you know, this is good. Anyway, I think we're going to walk to the... What was it? The,
arcade.
Mm-hmm. The arcade. I want to look at some things there. Okay, so if you've ever joined us from our Canberra adventures from last September, I annoyed Samia with a whistle pop because I'd never tried one and she let me try one in Canberra when we were at the arcade.
It was so a mistake.
We went back to the arcade and I can't do this one-handed.
Good.
No, yes I can.
Ew.
Anyway, she also got one, but... I annoy her with it all the time, every time I'm with her.
Alright, so I am back from Sydney and this brings us to the end of my Taylor Swift The Eras Tour era. The two concerts I got was absolutely amazing. My part one of this vlog was the Melb concert, so that had more of my live reactions to everything as it happened live because... that was my first time experiencing the Eras Tour live. I didn't get quite as emotional in this concert, but I was absolutely stoked and surprised at the surprise songs that we got. Haunted and Exile was never a combination that I would have imagined getting. I always wanted to experience Exile live as a surprise song after seeing it in the US portion of the tour. But I accepted my fate and I was like, I don't think I'm ever going to hear that live, but a part of me always wanted to. Same with Haunted, and the fact that I got both of those in the same night completely blew me away. And Is It Over Now is actually a song that while I was in Canberra with my friend would come on the radio a lot of times over January, and we would constantly be singing it on the radio together, so that was a really special moment. And I wish it would, I mean, you can't go wrong with that song, it's such a good song. So anyway, that was a wrap on Tales of the Eras Tour. The entire tour itself blew my expectations. Any expectations I had, it was above and beyond it, and it was crazy. I
I loved it so much. If I could have experienced it another time, as many times as I could until the tour's over, I would. But unfortunately, I don't have the funds or the, you know, everything sold out in every other country, and I am busy myself. Stay tuned for a couple maybe covers inspired by my Eras Tour shows or some vlogs that I have coming up. It is looking to be quite an exciting and fun year of adventures and things I have planned, so stay tuned for that. And yeah, I can't wait to see you guys in my next vlog, and thanks for coming along on this Eras Tour journey with you. I hope you enjoyed watching the concerts as I did experiencing them live, and I'm gonna definitely be rewatching my videos as memories. So yeah, until next time, bye.
Hey guys, so I thought I would do a quick story time on how I got this Taylor Swift the Eras Tour physical ticket from Accor in Sydney for the Night 3 concert. And I know you can't get one of these when you normally buy tickets, so it's pretty cool to have it. So I'm keeping it as a keepsake for the Eras Tour. So let's get into the story on how this all came about to be. So I went to the Sydney show in Accor, and I also have been to Melbourne Night 1. And you know, my friend and I got there, and I was like, oh, based on the Melbourne times, like, the wait to get into the venue isn't actually very long, and they haven't really sectioned off everything, so you can pretty much walk wherever you want. So my friend and I were supposed to be sitting separately for the concert based on tickets that I had. And so I walk her to her gate, which has no line, and get her in, and the Accor security was like, you can only go through your specified gate. So I was like, okay, I'm just gonna go back to gate one, where I'm supposed to be, or gate A. So I walk out and get her in, and then I walk all the way over to gate A, which her gate was gate E. So A and E are on the same side of the stadium at Accor. So I just walked over, and when I look at gate A, there is like a 20 meter line, and I can't, it like goes all the way back up to the food trucks and loops around again. And I was like, oh my gosh, this is so long. So there's about 20 minutes till Sabrina comes on, and Sabrina is mine and especially my friend's, one of her favorite artists. So I was like, oh, I can't let her miss that. And I wanted to go watch it with her as well. But I had already seen her Melbourne Night 1, but I would kill to watch Sabrina again. So I quickly make my way in this crowd, and I realize that a lot of people are shoving in, so I also just try and shove my way in, kind of make it through gate A. And what I realize is that as I'm getting closer and closer to the security checks and scanning your tickets and getting in, is that gate A is solely for people on level 6. So I'm like, oh crap, she's on level 1 because that's where her ticket is, but my ticket's on level 6, so I'm like, how am I gonna, you know, get to her at all? So I walk up the spiral staircase, and I'm sprinting up there, because by the time I get to the spiral staircase to walk all the way up, it's actually a ramp. It was already 6:10 and Sabrina gets on at 6:20 sharp. So I make my way up all the top, and I realize there's nowhere to get down. It's either I go all the way down to the ground floor and I walk out, so, you know, I walk, or I walk all the way up level 6 and just stay, and I'm on the phone with my friend being like, hey, I can't get to you, like, you should just go enjoy Sabrina, I'm just gonna enjoy it, we'll just enjoy the concert separately and I'll see you later. And she was like, no, we should just try. And I was like, I literally can't get to you, there is no way I can get to you. Okay, so Accor at level 6 is really steep. I'll see if I can insert like a photo or something. I don't really know how to use TikTok and all the green screen things, but let me see if I can do it. Okay, so this is the view from level 6. You can't tell how steep it is here, but it's a long way down at 6 levels, you know, and this is why I got scared. So here's what happened next. So I get out of my aisle seat, and my friend was like, hey, it's better to sort it out during Sabrina than Taylor, which got me to want to move out and just get this sorted out, because I didn't really want to miss Sabrina, but I also wanted to miss Taylor a lot less than missing Sabrina. So I run out, and I'm hysterically crying at this point. I've already texted my friends, other group chats, being like, I'm sobbing, I'm like actually so scared, this is so scary, like I can't be up here by myself. So I walk over to the nearest Accor person I could find, and they were like, oh, you just walk down the ramp to level 1 and it'll get you back to level 1. And I was like, are you sure? Because that took me from outside all the way up to level 6. Like,
inside the stadium. And he was like, yeah, do it. And then the lady who was next to him was also working out a court, and she was like, you walk down the ramp to level one, down, down. Like, she was like screaming and yelling at me, and I was like just trying to make sure, because the ramp that I had seen is one had red and white tape blocked across it, and two, the other one just took you out from to the outside, and that's not what I wanted to get into. So they weren't helpful, and I was still hysterically crying at this point. So I go up to these two security guys, and I'm like, hey, I just need to get to level one. Like, my friend's down there. I need to get to her. I just can't be up here by myself. I'm just so scared, and I just really need to get to her. She's in level one. How do I do that? And my friend's out here, like, texting me, calling me, having terrible reception, and trying not to miss Sabrina, I'm sure. So I feel so guilty for making her go through all this with me and missing her Sabrina set that she wanted to watch. And these security guards were so nice, and they were like, oh, are you okay though? And I was like, he's like, we can take you down the lift to level one. I was like, where's the lift? And they actually said they'll bring me to the lift because I was crying. And they were like, are you okay though? I was like, I don't know, I'm just really scared up here. Like, I'm like shaking, I can't like be up here, it's too high, it's too scary for me. And the guard's like, okay, no problem. He's like, we'll just get you down to level one, it's okay, and we'll sort it out. So they talk to a duty manager who talks to another duty manager who talks to another duty manager, finally gets me down to level one. I wait outside, can't even go in at this point. Some guy manager brings me inside, and he's like, just wait here. And he's like, so you want to get relocated to level one? I was like, yes. And I'm also trying to text my friend, figure out where she is, because Sabrina's playing this entire time. And, you know, we're just like trying to sort this all out before Taylor comes, before Sabrina finishes, because I want to at least catch the rest of Sabrina's set. So this duty manager comes back to me after telling me to wait right there and hands me this ticket. And he's like, I have one ticket available for relocation. Do you want it? And I was like, yes, I'll take it. He's like, it is restricted for you though. So you're going to have to just keep that in mind. And it says down here, side view or restricted view. And I was like, that's okay, I just need level one. And this is actually better than my seat where it was originally, because this is a C reserve restricted view ticket, I believe. And mine was an E reserve ticket. Even though my view was not restricted with the E reserve originally, I would have much rather taken this than sat up in level six and been crying for the whole concert. After he hands me this is an aisle 101, and my friend is an aisle 115, which is quite a walk away. So I spot her and I sprint to her, and I'm like, what do you want to do? Do you want to go to my section or do you want to go to yours, and we can just figure out what to do? So she was like, let's just hang out with my section for a bit. So we watched the rest of Sabrina set there, and we're trying to see if we can actually move over and like get people to move over, because she's number seven, which is like a couple seats off the aisle, and see if I can squeeze in with her at the aisle, because we've heard stories of a lot of people doing it at a core at Taylor the Eras tour, and we thought we could do it as well, because we kind of wanted to sit with each other. So we watched the rest of Sabrina's set together at her seat, and the ladies who are sitting on the aisle were like, no, we handpicked these seats, like you can't make us move. So we're like, okay, no worries. So it's about 7:10 and Taylor Swift gets on at 7:30 sharp. And so we were like, how about we just go to my section? It's a restricted view section. Maybe there'll be less people there and we can just figure it out. If we have to sit the rest of the concert separate, that's fine. We'll just do it. So we get over to the restricted view section, where it is this seat. And we find out that there is a completely empty row behind us, and my row only has side seats filled. So it's about 7:25. Just before 7:25, and the lady's like, hey, you need to get to your seats. If not, then security's gonna come and tell you off, and you need to be at your seat. Do you know where your seat is? And we're like, oh yeah, sure, we do. So I say, hey, why don't you just like come sit with me for now? If you have to move, so be it. Just move during the concert. If not, then well, you get to sit with me for the rest of the show. So she was like, okay, well, I'll just hop in here. So there was no one there, and we're looking around, and there's still no one there, and it's feeless, and there's no one there. The seats behind us are slowly getting filled, but like very late into the concert. So figured out that these seats, and the reason why this row was left empty and the row behind us was empty, is for anyone who is relocating the seats during the concert or right before the concert for any kind of reason. And I'll quickly show you, because I only have 30 seconds left, what the view ended up looking like. And this is the view we ended up with. These were the seats
That was the restricted view seats that I had, and she just popped in right next to me, and there was no one there for the rest of the concert, so that was just an entirely free seat for the night. So she just got to enjoy the concert with me, which was great. And there is what our seat looks like. This is slightly zoomed in, but it was a great view. And here's a photo of me at the restricted view section. That's the rest of the view.